At the end of this month, end of January 2021, the CDC and the United States are come to agreement in terms of any travelers that are coming into the country. They have to show a bug test that was taken within the last 3 days negative in order to enter into the country. And the catch is that not only foreign travelers, you know, have this requirement, but also U.S. citizens. So this kind of may put a little bit of a damper into not only me personally in terms of travel plans, but just anybody in general, because, you know, when you think about it, 3 days prior, that means that wherever country, you know, whatever country that you're in, you have to, you know, get tests there locally. More than likely, you have to pay out of pocket. And then in terms of having to deal with the communication, like how are you going to, you know about your results? But the big thing is if you, for some reason, get tested negative, then you're not allowed to, if you're tested positive, then you're not allowed to board that plane back to the States. What you have to do then is pretty much quarantine to the country that you're at. And then you obviously have to think about, okay, where am I going to stay at for the next week or so? And then again, having to pay for another test and then pay for another plane ticket once your test comes back positive. So these are all kind of like questions that, you know, somebody, if they're planning a trip abroad, and this rule, for the time being, it's going to be implemented end of January. Who knows how long it's going to be in place, but could you imagine, let's say if you go to not even Europe, but let's say you go somewhere in South America or you go to Mexico, and then at the end of your trip, you know, I'm not, you know, thinking negative, but these are all valid questions that will come up, that, you know, you try to come back, but you test positive, then you have to pay for another week's worth of accommodation, food, you have to probably pay for another test, another plane ticket. These are all valid questions that, you know, you should think about when you're, if you're planning a trip in the next few months or so. You know, who knows how long this requirement's going to be, but for the time being, it's going to be implemented end of January, and it's definitely going to probably alter a lot of people's travel plans, especially American citizens. You know, if you're a foreign traveler, that's normal, because like for me, when I went to Croatia, I had to present a negative test. But this is essentially wherever you're going, you have to take a test in that country. And let's just say that, you know, you're a tourist, so you weren't home all the time. You were probably out and about traveling, you know, seeing the place, probably talking to the locals, whatnot. Not saying that you're going to automatically catch something, but there is a chance, and you have to plan on taking a test there. And it's like, what happens if you test positive? And all of a sudden, instead of it being a cool, you know, nice getaway vacation, now it's become like, oh man, I have to deal with all this extra stuff that I had no, you know, did not want to deal with at all. So guys, I wanted to make this video to kind of notify that, one, for foreign travelers coming to the States, this is going to be a requirement. That's pretty normal. I think a lot of the EU, the European countries that are not open, like for example, Croatia, they require you to bring a negative test. That's normal, but it's probably more so for American citizens, because this rule is in place for American citizens as well, is that should you leave the country, when you try to come back, you have to present a negative test, unless you're going somewhere for like 2 days. But no, let's assume that you're going somewhere for a week to 2 weeks. You essentially have to plan on finding a facility there, taking a test 3 days prior, making sure that it's negative for you to board your return flight home. And in the event that should you test positive, essentially you probably have to extend your time there for, I would say, a minimum another week, and have to buy another COVID test, and then have to buy another return flight, you know, back after assuming you test negative the second time around. And it sounds like these are all just kind of unnecessary tasks, risks to take at this point, obviously depending on your situation. This, me personally, it's kind of maybe affecting what I have planned in the spring. More to come on that, but I just wanted to quickly notify, and for those of you who are not aware of this new rule that's going to be taken, I think in place end of January. That's where it's going to be a requirement. So guys, we'll see. Again, everything's changing pretty much month to month. So we'll see after this rule's in place what's going to happen next and how long it's going to be implemented for. So guys, with that, more to come. So stay up to date. Again, thanks so much for watching the video. You guys are watching, so please like, please subscribe. That'll help a ton for the channel. And I'll talk to you guys in the next video. Bye.